Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and another welcome from Leeds Minster. I've got five pieces to play for you. They're all pretty short. And it starts with a piece called Fanfare for Francis, written by Noel Rawsthorne. And Noel wrote this in 2007 to commemorate Francis's 90th birthday, Francis Jackson's 90th birthday. And he puts a little amusing introduction verbally like this. Prior to an evening recital, it was always a great delight to sit up in the organ loft in York to listen to Francis accompanying evensong and to hear an improvised sortie at the end of the service. Fanfare for Francis is a birthday present inspired by such occasions, with a few of his crunchy progressions and what I used to call nutty slack chords, plus a few tuba tunes thrown in for good luck. So it's a very affectionate trumpet tune and great fun to play. I follow that with a short intermediate movement from Paul Hindemith's second sonata. And, well now, Hindemith wrote sonatas and concertos for pretty well every combination under the sun you can think of. I have horrible nightmares remembering a performance I had to accompany on the piano of a tuba sonata. The sonata was set for grade 8 tuba, and I reckon the piano part was about grade 16, so it was a bit of a headache. Anyhow, this is from Hindemith's second organ sonata. It's called Ruhig Bewegt, and it's quite a nice little pastoral movement, actually. Now, Hindemith his music was originally tarred with the description of Gebrauchsmusik, which translates horribly as utility music, i.e. music, if you like, without flair and without purpose. Later on in life, Hindemith disowned this term. He hadn't actually invented it, but anyhow, it's not really Gebrauchsmusik. I think it's a rather sweet pastoral. That's followed by two pieces with LPC connections, starting off with The Choral Song by S.S. Wesley. Now, this particular tune, I reckon, is pretty well, if you like, the national anthem of Leeds Parish Church, probably written for here, I would hope, and if I had a £10 note for every time I've played it, I'd be quite rich by now. I'd like to follow that with a piece by a somewhat later organist of Leeds Parish Church, that is to say, Dr. Simon Lindley, and it's a rather sweet piece. It's called Dr. Spedding's Galliard, and it was written as an affectionate tribute to the late Dr. Alan Spedding of Beverley Minster. And Dr. Spedding's Galliard is a rather sweet tune, and it's based apparently upon a melody by John Dowland. Anyhow, it's rather sweet, and it finishes on a nice chord of G major with the added ninth, and I reckon that's a Dr. Lindley trademark, because I've had to play that chord on various other accompaniments that he's written. Finally, a piece by Walter Schindler. Now, Walter Schindler apparently lived to the great age of 99, and as far as we can tell, and this is based on, you know, Wikipedia or Google or whatever it might be, He seems to have been almost a one-work composer. I hope I'm not doing him down there. But it's this Kleine Toccata, and it's on the original chorale tune, Eine feste Burg ist unser Gott. And Schindler wrote it in 1949. I reckon it's a rather original concept, actually. There's some rather wicked writing for the pedals, solo, and also the chorale melody is actually jazzed up rather, and it's accompanied by a very spiky mixtures combination, so it's mixtures with the Jubilee trumpet. But yes, I like this piece. It is Kleiner, it only lasts about 3 minutes or so, so that's the programme, and I hope you like it.